can't go in the scriptures and show that, man. Because they in denial of that. Motherfuckers in straight denial, man.
Right, because the Lord, yeah, leprosy is a curse that the Lord put on Israel. Dude. The Lord cursed whole generations of people. Like, we went into that before about Joab. He cursed all of his lineage and all of his generations. So all of his descendants would have leprosy and have pain and bad health. And you see a lot of these leprous jakes too, bro. They be all fucked up. You know what I mean?
Fucked up. Just like, you know.
They just like, yeah, just like Judah.
No fucking difference.
And a lot of them might be, they probably are Judah, the kingdom of Judah. Benjamin, Judah, Levi. Yeah, common, because, yeah, Jake is everywhere, man. That's why the scripture said, try the spirits.
Jacob got Kunani and all different kind of flavors. That's what we need when we come down like that.
She got her own little house. Too bad she can't fit in it.
It's a
girl.
I think we're gonna take one from the Israelites.
Well, that's why the scripture said in King David. It said King David went to the Edom. Went to Edom. It said he's smitten every male in Edom. But it said every male. So what do you think? He spared the females. What do you think they did with the females? You don't just go killing all the females. Right? Why would you want to do that? That's crazy.
I gotta just understand some of them motherfuckers must die.
Yeah.
Not all them fine bitches.
Hell no.
Shit.
They can afford the gym membership. Ain't none of these raggedy ass Israelite hoes working out going to the gym. They are home eating pork chops, bratwurst, bacon, sitting on the couch, watching cable TV, watching Netflix. Oh, chilling Netflix. That's what they doing. Yeah, watch them. Watch them porn, they make them porn. They the stars. Israelite bitches are the porno queen.
Go ahead. They want to act like you don't want to. They want to act like they don't think about sex all the time.
Yeah,
right.
Their minds is in the gutter, where it belongs. That's how they were made.
That's why they so susceptible to the serpent. You know what I mean?
Here we go, verse 28. For I will lay the land most desolate, and the pomp of her strength shall cease, and the mountains of Israel shall be desolate, that none shall pass through. Then shall they know that I am the Lord, when I have laid the land most desolate because of all their abominations which they have committed.
Right, so that's how we, that's how these fools, they finally gonna know that the Lord was real and he wasn't playing games, is when the land is laid desolate. And when that destruction and that fire comes, then they gonna know. They gonna be no doubt about who was running shit on that day. You know what I mean? Ain't gonna be no doubt about that one. The Lord gonna show that, man. He's gonna put the, talking about the fear of the Lord. Y'all gonna have the fear of the Lord in you. It's gonna happen.
Hey, check it out. I gotta go back up to 37, man. Because we the Lord's mouthpiece, man. This is his mouth speaking. Thou son of man, so thou, O son of man, I have set thee a watchman unto the house of Israel. Therefore thou shalt hear the word at my mouth and warn them from me. So this is the Lord speaking.
Yeah, so we come in. Right. The Lord himself ain't going to come down here.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
He speak through us.
Like, right, before every nation that fell in the past, the Lord always sent his prophets out to warn you of the destruction. So now we tell you the destruction is coming. America's going to be destroyed. And that's what's happening. That's what time, we in a time, in the age of destruction and desolation. And Trump is going to be the man to bring that destruction too. He thinks he's a, you know, a badass. He thinks he can go bully all these other nations. It ain't going to happen. America's going to be destroyed. All of its allies are going to turn on America. And all these countries in the world are going to shoot missiles on America. And that's going to be the end of it. Ain't going to be no more America.
Also, thou son of man, the children of thy people still are talking against thee by the walls and in the doors of the houses.
Look, Israel loves talking shit about the Lord.
Come on, man.
Who else could that be talking about? So who else could the Israelites be, right? It really is.
I'm still, 33.
Because don't know whether people fit those characteristics. The only backslided, shit-talking, murmuring-ass people is these fools out here. They the only ones that fit that description, man. They're the children of Israel.
Also, thou son of man, the children of thy people still are talking against thee by the walls and in the doors of the houses, and speak one to another, every one to his brother, saying, come, I pray you, and hear what is the word that cometh forth from the Lord. And they come unto thee as the people come, and they sit before thee as my people, and they hear thy words, but they will not do them.
Right. Because we be at the bus stop, too. You had these murmuring-ass Israelites. They be over there whispering to each other. Them motherfuckers are full of shit. They full of hate. That's some bullshit they talking about. That Bible's some bullshit. And that's what they over there murmuring. Just murmuring. You know what I'm saying? Talking all that bullshit.
But with their mouth, they show much love. Just like that.
Oh, yeah. They y'all had, yeah.
Remember how he was all agreement before?
Those come up and show us love and go to the bus stop and talk shit about us.
But their heart goeth after their confessions. And lo, thou art unto them as a very lovely song of one that hath a pleasant voice, and can play well on an instrument, for they hear thy words, but they do them not.
Hey, they don't do the word.
And when this cometh to pass, lo, it will come, then shall they know that a prophet hath been among them.
Oh, that's a good one right there. Yeah, they gonna know, bro. Yeah, they gonna figure that shit out real quick. You know what I'm saying? When the Lord returns, bro.
Real quick.
That's gonna be the last thing they figured out. I can't wait, man, because this shit got to be destroyed. This shit's got to go, man.
Reading the Solomon 12:17. Though when men will not believe that thou art of a full power, thou showest thy strength, and among them that know it, thou makest their boldness manifest.
So go ahead.
But thou, mastering thy power, judges with authority, and orders us with great favor, for thou mayest use power when thou wilt. But by such works have thou taught thy people that the just man should be merciful and have.
The nation of Israel, we Israelites.
Have made thy children to be of a good hope that thou givest. But thou didst punish the enemies of thy children, and condemned to death for such deliberation, giving them time and place, whereby they might be delivered from their malice. But how much?
I'll go ahead and read that.
With how great circumspection dost thou judge thy own sons until his father died, torn, and they come into the promise. Therefore, when thou didst thus cast on us, that scourges our enemies 1,000 times more.
Right, you think the Lord jacking us up. Just wait till you see what he does to these damn devils, man. This way you see what he does to Esau, the so-called white people running shit out here. We see what happens to them for creating this fucking shit we live in. You want to see what kind of punishment they got. Y'all thought slavery of the so-called black man was bad? Wait till you see what Esau gets.
To the intent that when we judge, we should carefully think of thy goodness, and when we ourselves are judged, we should look for mercy. Wherefore, whereas men have lived disorderly and unrighteously, thou hast tormented them with me with their own abomination. For they went astray very far in the way of error, and held them for gods which even among the beasts of their enemies were despised, being deceived as children of no understanding. Therefore, unto them as to the children without the use of reason, thou didst send a judgment to mock them. But they...
Yeah, so the Lord's going to mock these fools when he returns with that judgment. And then he's going to laugh at you. Just like Psalms 2 says, the Lord sits in the heavens, he's laughing at you fools. He's going to vex you with a sore displeasure. And we're going to laugh. And we're going to be sipping on that fine wine up in the chariots, celebrating your destruction and celebrating the destruction of America. That the Lord is going to destroy America by fire.
You've been warned, man. Over and over and over. Been warned, man. So if somebody you've been, if you, man, we come out here all the time. We say all the time, we come out here week after week, man, warning these people. So they're worthy. The end justified, what's the saying? The end justified the means.
And these fools in their simple minds, they think, oh, fire can't come out of the sky and destroy America. Okay. Okay.
Hiroshima and Nagasaki.
Yeah, Hiroshima and Nagasaki. What do you think Russia's going to do to America? Russia's going to shoot missiles on America. It ain't going to be no more America. It's going to be a pile of ashes and smoke. That's what it's going to be. And then we're going to praise the Lord. Yeah, that vexed that Edomite spirit right there. He had to get up out of there. He didn't want to hear. His precious America's out of there.
His people. His truth represents the end of his people. Actually, this is only his end.
Feasting off another man's bread, you know what I mean? He made his riches by oppressing the poor. You know what I'm saying? Robbing the poor, robbing the weak. That's where these devils got all their money and their riches, by taxing poor people. You know what I'm saying? You go to work every day, working damn 8 hours a day, 10 hours a day, you know, 6 days a week, barely got enough money to pay rent, and they still taxing you. They don't care about you. You're just a slave. That's all you are. And that's why this devil's got to go. That's why the Lord's going to destroy America. Y'all got something?
He said, God did send judgment to mock them. It's funny because you know fucking they trying to say pretty much that they don't need the Lord, so on and so forth. But when that shit is the fans, they be crying on to them like they, you know, like they need them and shit. It's gonna be funny because like, oh, what happened?
They said they was ready for them, you know. Oh, shit. That's what they think, man. They think they're ready. They think they're prepared over there. That's some funny shit, man. That's some funny shit.
Verse 26, but they that would not be warned by that correction wherein he dwelt with them shall feel judgment worthy of God. But look, for what they guard treasure.
You let your child, you keep telling the child to do something, and he don't do it. After 3 or 4 times, you see you out fucking how your anger gonna multiply and whoop his ass. You know what I'm saying? Shit, that's an ass whoop we give our to.
Yep.
How much more the Heavenly Father when after he done warned your stupid ass enough fucking times?
And the scriptures say that say the Lord is long suffering. May he give you he's merciful, bro. The Lord is merciful.
That's why they still alive walking.
Exactly.
He's merciful. He's giving them a chance.
But look for what things they grudge it when they were punished. This that is right. For them who they brought to be gods, now being punishing them when they saw it, they acknowledge him to be the true God.
Yeah, the true God. The true power of Israel. Okay, y'all going they gonna find out the hard way, bro.
The hard way. Stiff-headed, the hard-headed.
Before they denied to know,
and therefore came extreme damnation upon them.
Extreme is damnation.
Extreme damnation. That's what's coming. Is extreme damnation. Death by fire.
Extreme.
Hey, get that. We about to get that one. You never got it, Isaiah 66.
Isaiah 66:15. It says, "Behold, the Lord will come with fire and with his chariot like a whirlwind to render his anger with fury and his rebuke with flames of fire. But by fire and by his sword will the Lord plead with all flesh, and the slain of the Lord shall be many."
Right, so the scripture said the slain of the Lord shall be many. Why is that? Because there's a whole lot of wicked ass people out here that don't fear the Lord. That they don't follow the instructions of the Lord. So they gonna die. It's that simple. See, the truth is simple. You follow, you don't do what you say, you die. Simple. The Lord said there's a simplicity in your halashah. That's something simple to understand. You know what I'm saying? You blaspheme the Lord's going to destroy you. And that's why there's a great destruction coming to America. That's what. Hey, read that again, man.
It says, Isaiah 66:15, "For behold, the Lord will come with fire and his chariot like a whirlwind to render his anger with fury and his rebuke with flames of fire."
It's rebuke. The Lord going to rebuke you with flames of fire. Go ahead.
"For by fire and by sword will the Lord plead with all flesh, and the slain of the coward shall be many."
The slain of the, right. It's Lord is, Most High's name is Yahweh. The slain of Yahweh shall be many. Okay, because America's out of there, bro. The Lord's bringing that fire. There ain't no stopping. Y'all gonna see some wild, crazy stuff on that day when the Lord returns out of the sky with those chariots. And that's gonna be beautiful.
Extreme tour.
Like everybody just walking around like everything's okay. Walk around a la la land. You know what I'm saying? You don't, you don't. People are damn zombies, bro. Everybody walking around like everything's all good. Ain't nothing good. There's not a damn thing good about this country, this piece of shit world. There ain't nothing but filth out here. And y'all good with all this filth. You know what I'm saying? Colonel Sanders.
Amos 5:16, "Therefore the Lord, the power of hosts, the Lord, saith thus."
Yeah, the army, the Lord of hosts. A host is an army. You know, you didn't say that to one of these fat bitches, they think it's a hostess, a cupcake. The Lord of hosts is the Lord of armies. That's why you read all through the New Testament and say when the Lord returns to the earth, he's coming out the sky with the holy host of angels, with the legions of angels. What, that's those chariots, so-called UFOs. And they coming to bring death and destruction. And they gonna come and they gonna save the elect of Israel. Go ahead.
Simultaneously coming to slay the wicked.
Exactly. But you know, these people, they can't, the average person, that don't make sense to them. They think that's just some bullshit, you know what I mean? Y'all gonna find out the truth sooner than later.
Thus, wailing shall be in all streets.
Yeah, there's going to be some weeping and wailing in these streets.
All streets.
In all these streets. They already weeping and wailing. It's going to get worse.
Ain't going to be safe over now.
Nope.
And they shall say in all the highways, alas, alas, and they shall call the husbandmen to mourning, and such as are skillful in lamentation to wailing, and in all vineyards shall be wailing. For I will pass through thee, saith the Lord. Woe unto you that desire the day of the Lord. To what end is it for you? The day of the Lord is darkness and not light.
Yeah, the day of the Lord is darkness and not light. And when the Lord returns to the earth, there ain't gonna be nothing but death and destruction. And that's gonna be the end of this world as you know it.
End of Esau's rule. As if a man did flee from a lion, and a bear met him, or went into the house and leaned his hand on the wall, and a serpent bit him, shall not the day of the Lord be darkness and not light? Even very dark, and no brightness in it. I hate, I despise your feast day.
Yeah, the Lord hates and despises your feast day. The Lord hates Christmas. And we coming up on Easter. And Easter is found nowhere in the Bible. Okay? The Israelites did not celebrate Easter. The one you call Jesus Christ did not celebrate Easter. He celebrated a Passover. The word Easter comes from an ancient Babylonian goddess of fertility named Ishtar. Now, but now we talk about facts, you know, that facts and information that don't resonate with people. You know what I'm saying? Go ahead with that.
And I will not smell of in your solemn assemblies. Though ye offer me burnt offerings and your meat offerings, I will not accept them. Neither will I regard the peace offerings of your fat beasts.
Right, that's why you got a lot of Israelites out here talking about they some Old Testament only Israelites. Well, guess what? The Lord said, fuck your sacrifices. You know what I mean? That's why the Lord had to come.
Or just totally disregard the Lord's sacrifice.
Exactly. So how are they sins forgiven? The Lord's not accepting their sacrifice.
They got the power in their own
hands. They sound foolish. That's that foolish talk.
The power in their own hands. They deliver their own souls. Take thou away from me the noise of thy songs.
Yeah.
I will not hear them.
Yeah, the Lord said, take away from me the noise of thy song. All that bullshit music y'all be listening, that evil music y'all listen to. All these little rap songs talking about murdering people, talking about I fucked your bitch, you know what I'm saying? Shooting people. All that music's all about murder, death, robbery, adultery. That's evil, you know what I'm saying? When you be making music, you're supposed to make music to glorify the Lord, not glorifying yourself. What's that? Nate Smith, they glorifying themselves, bro. They just think they getting their shine on, bro. That's vanity. Yeah, the IUIC making rap videos. That's because
they ain't got nothing else to do. When they're supposed to push the word,
right?
They ain't got nothing else to do, so they making videos.
They claiming they not praising. They getting vain glory.
Right.
They just hoping people hit the like button on the YouTube. You know what I'm saying?
Tell them there's all posing and shit. Like, you know what I mean? They gotta, like, you know, posing whatever. You put a little humble and shit. You ain't put it all.
If you gonna make music, do it the right way. Not all trying to get your shine on. You know what I'm saying?
Two things. When the house I sung a hymn. It was a hymn. I appreciate he read the book. He sung the book of songs, but anyway.
Yeah.
And John the Baptist said, I must decrease. Three, Northwest Boulevard, Kansas.
Yep.
Every single song in the book of songs, you never seen the book of songs that the Lord, King David said, I'm no weak and shit. You always say, how was this and how was that?
Yeah, exactly.
Praise him.
Hey, I got a scripture for that too. I can get it real quick. I think it's Colossians.
3, Northwest Boulevard.
Get a precept for that. Because gospel music, well, then I said gospel music. That's a whole nother thing. That's just satanic too.
Gospel about it.
Exactly. Ain't no kind of news.
Right.
No good news.
No. And that's what gospel means.
They praising Caesar Bolger.
Gospel. You know what gospel is supposed to be speaking of? Prosperity. You know? You're going to be all right after you throw that man out. With some Lord Jesus with you. Motherfucker. Oh, God.
I got
a scripture. Unction from the Most High, but not according to the wisdom.
Oh, that's the spirit.
You know what I'm saying?
Look, Colossians 3 and 16. Let the word of Yahweh Shai dwell in you richly in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your hearts to the Lord. And whatsoever ye do in word or deed, do all in the name of Yahweh Shai Mashiach, giving thanks to the Lord and the Father by him. Right, because a lot of these, they make that music because they just want to get their shine on. You know what I'm saying? That's why we say, yo, we live in that egocentric society. Everybody just care about their self. That's why people, they addicted to Facebook, because everybody want to be popular. You know what I'm saying? Everybody wants to be number one.
What?
Go ahead.
I seen that one video. It was Shikari's group. They was like, they have making rap video, of course. But,
oh, God.
Yeah, one dude had a face mask and shit. Mm-hmm. Dude had like a little blade.
Shit.
Right. Like, you know, sweet.
Yeah, right. They think they cool, man. That's of the world. Little blades and shit. Man, get the fuck out of here with that shit, man.
Some motherfuckers have no oil, man. That's why they do that shit.
But that's why he said you're not supposed to worship Yahweh Shai. It's a card.
Video.
Yeah, it's crazy as hell saying something like that.
That's some blasphemy shit.
Yeah, it's blasphemy.
Ooh.
You have to deal with that, Sakari.
Yeah.
Oh, you, hey, that mate, they call themselves Sakari. That's a gnomon omen, because you're going to get cut. You know what I mean? The Lord go, chop you up and slice you up into pieces. Talking about you ain't supposed to worship your Yahweh Shai. Are you fucking crazy? That's bugged out. Hey, that's the Lord that did that to him, though. That's the funny part. That's the joke. But the Lord is the king of all jokes.
But let judgment run down. Righteousness of the county stream. Have you offered unto me sacrifice and offerings in the wilderness 40 years, O house of Israel? But ye have ruined the tabernacle of your Moloch and Shion in the image, the star of your God, which ye made to yourselves.
Yeah, because Moloch is the, That's the God of America. It's Baal, Moloch, the devil, Satan. You know what I mean? All different names for the same thing, Satan. They worship Moloch. That's why they celebrate Christmas. And a lot of they don't even know why they do it. But we telling you that's why they do it. And that goes back to those ancient devil worshiping holidays. Like Christmas, Easter, Halloween. That all goes back to ancient devil worship. Sacrificing the children to Moloch. You got more to that? That was the point.
You
just talking about they got his Moloch. They got his Baal.
First thing these people do is they're gods. You chase after them. Tell them. All right, bro.
Let me get that.
Here it is, we out here in the rain. They should think of it. That should immediately tell these motherfuckers. They got a point they're pushing out this, you know. We're out here for a purpose. We're out here in the motherfucking rain and shit. We're not out here for the rain to take a shower.
Let me get that scripture you quoted, the first commandment. Matthew 22 and 37. Actually, let me start at 36. Master.
I don't know.
What's that?
I was looking too. I was wondering if it was a man or a woman. I couldn't tell.
That's where you're in Babylon. You just confusing out here.
Right. I swear I could not tell.
Matthew 22 and 36. Master, which is the great commandment in the law? Yehoshua said unto him, Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment. And the second is like unto it. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. So that these people don't love the Lord. They don't love Yahweh. They don't love the Most High. You know what I'm saying? They don't love their neighbor.
But like, I don't quote Apostle Bar, because it was like the same scripture you just read. You know, he said, I would say that you should love with all your heart. He said, that this truth becomes you for your life. It's the only thing you think when you wake up, it's what you think, before you go to sleep, it's what you think.
That's it. That's right.
And you constantly just pray and he destroys this shit. Like the Lord's Prayer. Hey, get the Lord's Prayer, that we in that time.
Exodus 20 and 1. The Most High spake all these words, saying, I am the Lord thy power, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage.
Out of the house of bondage. Oh, that's the spirit. I was just reading that in the Hebrew this morning. And it says bondage in the Hebrew, but really says in Hebrew is ibadjim. Because you know, ibad in Hebrew means what? Servant. And ibadjim means servants or slaves. So, because Egypt is the house of slaves. It's like America. How was America founded? It was on slavery. And America is still sustained by slavery. Okay? There's more prisoners in America than the rest of the world combined. I think there's something like over 4 million prisoners. I was just looking up the number.
Still picking up steam.
It's crazy. And now Donald Trump, he's trying to put even more people in prison so they get more free slave labor. That's what those prisons is all about, is free slave labor. And that's how this country is always operating.
Clever. That's clever.
Yeah, that's clever. They just changed the name from slave to prisoner. You know what I mean?
This devil is slick, man. Thou shalt have no other gods before me.
Hey, you see people on it always taking up for cops and shit. Taking up for the government. Y'all some bitches. You know what I mean? That's what y'all are, some punk-ass bitches, man. Taking up for cops and the government. Y'all some homeborn slaves. Suffer from Stockholm Syndrome, ain't got a lick of sense in you. You know what I mean? Oh, we need a police. Who you gonna call it? Now I'm gonna call the Lord, that's who. Yeah, exactly. You call the cops, they gonna shoot you, arrest you. You gonna have an old warrant you didn't even know about or something. You going to jail.
All you need is righteous men that's able to execute judgment righteously. That's all the fuck you need, man. And those righteous men need a fucking blade. Or a hammer, you know.
We call it, hey.
You know, Thor, that hammer ain't no joke.
Hey, the Lord said, is not the word of the Lord like a hammer to break up the rock into pieces?
That's all you need, man. You need righteous men with the tool. Their tool of choice, man. You know? That's all you need, man.
Hey, David took down Goliath with a sling.
Shot it like a gun. Shot
it
like a shotgun.
It hit him right in the middle of his damn forehead and it sunk.
It sunk up in his big ass forehead.
And Goliath dropped dead. So really, America is likened unto Goliath, that giant, that mighty power.
Woo.
You know what I'm saying?
It's
going to get hit in that forehead with that stone. Hey, that great millstone. The Lord going to hurl that great millstone. You know what I'm saying? Like that mighty angel cast a great millstone into this son of a bitch.
Daniel said, Yahusha was that stone that was cast on the feet of the statue.
Yep.
Man, if this ain't warning motherfuckers, what are we doing? If this ain't warning motherfuckers, man. This is pleasure, ain't it? Take pleasure in this, man. Because we know the end. We see the end.
Don't we have a scripture we might read? I had to do it. Yeah, read that.
Oh, Matthew 6.
Yeah, read that.
Yeah, I'm done with that.
Yeah, because we got to hear that.
I have no other gods before me.
Matthew 6 and 9. It says, after this manner, therefore pray ye, our Father,
which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Yeah, hallowed be thy name. And the Lord's name, the Most High's name is Yahweh. And his son's name is Yahweh Shai. And he tells you that when you pray to the Most High, you pray in his name. And that's why we say, before you pray, before you say this prayer, you say, Yahweh, Bahashem, Bah means in, Ha means the. So you say, Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai. And Sham means name, okay? Sham. Bahashem means in the name. So before you pray, you say, Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai. Go ahead. Read that again.
It says, after this manner, therefore pray ye, our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Hallowed be thy name. The Lord's name is holy. Keep going.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven.
Yeah, you're supposed to be praying that the kingdom of the Most High comes on this earth. Okay, and for the kingdom of the Most High to come, America's got to be destroyed. Okay? The Lord, for the Lord's kingdom to come on this earth, the kingdom of Satan, which we currently reside in, has to go. And it's going to go. So the kingdom of heaven is not going to come until America and the rest of these wicked nations are destroyed. And that's right there in the Lord's Prayer. So every time you say the Lord's Prayer, you're praying that the Lord destroys America, whether you know it or not. Go ahead.
Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors.
Yeah, we pray the Lord right now, since we in Satan's kingdom, we pray that he gives us what we need just to survive from day to day. Go ahead.
And lead us not into temptation.
Oh yeah, we ain't praying like the churches, the prosperity preachers, got you praying for money, praying for riches. The scriptures didn't say to pray for riches. It said to pray for your daily bread, enough to sustain yourself. Because that's all you need. Go ahead.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Yeah, we praying to the Lord, deliver us from that evil. Because it ain't nothing but evil out here. You know what I'm saying? That's why you pray to the Lord to deliver us from that evil. Go ahead. That's why we living in the scripture called the bloody city. Go ahead.
Real quick. So lead not into temptation. You gotta pray to the Lord, don't make you weak so you won't. First of all, bug out, you know, yep. Turn against the Lord.
And fall out.
Mainly, really, most to the chip, which is going to be the hardest test in your life.
Yeah, the microchip. Yeah, that they gave pushing.
Lead is not
lead us.
Yeah.
But deliver us.
There's a lot of temptations out here too. And plus, we like your brother say, when those pestilence come and all hell breaking loose, the economy collapses. They're going to implement that chip, that microchip, the mark of the beast. And you're going to see everybody else eating, and their bellies getting full. And you know what I'm saying? You got to make sure you don't get weak.
They're going to see the elect eating. Most of these motherfuckers going to be, stomachs going to be. Wow.
Right. And that day, the Lord's going to give us our daily bread.
That's right.
We'll find a way to eat.
The scripture says that day we're going to have plenty, but they shall, you know, maybe shall thirst.
Because Israel always got to be a comfort. You know what I'm saying? These people, they got to be in comfort. And they'll sell their soul to the devil so they can live in comfort. You know what I mean? Yeah, these people will sell out real quick when their stomach is growling. They sell out, you know what I'm saying, their brother. So how much more the Lord? You know what I'm saying?
For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Yeah, amen.
Sirach 18 and 23. Before thou prayest, prepare thyself and be not as one that tempteth the Lord. Think upon the wrath that shall be at the end.
Right, you ain't supposed to be praying to the Lord for riches, praying for a woman, a beautiful wife, a new house, a new car. That's a good way to get jacked up, you know what I mean? You supposed to be praying that the Lord's kingdom come.
He gives it to them too when they ask for that shit. He gives it to them too. You know? Ain't rash for the right shit. Ain't rash for the right thing.
And we supposed to be praying constantly that the Lord's kingdom come. And then all this shit gets destroyed, man.
It says, think upon the wrath that shall be at the end. We're constantly talking about it.
About the end of what?
You know? Like the end of what?
Oh yeah, because this is going, it's just coming to an end. You know what I mean?
and the time of vengeance when he shall turn away his face.
The time of vengeance? Is that sweet Jesus talking?
Yeah, that's sweet Jesus talking. That's his message. That's the gospel. Okay. Think upon the wrath that shall be at the end, and the time of vengeance when he shall turn away his face.
He turned away his face. It looks like, go ahead.
Like, that's why you got prayer to keep the spirit on you and have the outside Christian blameless. Because when that shit is the fan, it's like you're done. Like, no,
that's it.
You can't come back in.
That's it.
So you got to get right now and pray the Lord don't look. That's why you can't get proud and shit. And that's why we got to lean on the outside, because we can't do it ourselves. We can't be all righteous and shit. But because your outside really makes us blameless. Because when the Lord gets back, he's going to say, okay, this guy has no sin. But they're going to be looking at these motherfuckers. They're gonna be destroyed.
Yeah, that's right. When thou hast enough, remember the time of hunger. And when thou art rich, think upon poverty and need.
Right.
That's unheard of.
Right, so right. Hey, the Lord said what? He feeding the hungry or whatever. So you got money, you know what I'm saying? You're supposed to be helping brothers out. You know what I'm saying?
Is that motherfuckers, the last thing they know.
Right.
Get some riches. The Lord is far from their mind.
Because if I got riches, y'all got riches. You know what I'm saying? Because that was the Lord that gave it to me. You know I ain't got shit. Hey, the main riches is that truth. I'd rather have truth over rich gold and silver any day.
From the morning until the evening, the time is changed, and all things are soon done before the Lord. A wise man will fear in everything, and in the day of sinning, he will be aware of offenses.
Right, a wise man will be fearing all things. You know what I mean? We constantly fearing the Most High, every situation that we in. You be like, man, if I do this, I think the Lord's gonna fuck me up, so I'm not gonna do that. You know what I mean? While you driving down the street, you pray that the cops don't pull you over. Because they get behind you all the time. You know what I mean? Shit, why, I be riding my bike on the street. I'm praying I don't get pulled over on my bike. They will pull you over on a bike. Give you a ticket for not having a helmet. You know what I'm saying? If you ride on the sidewalk, they give you a ticket. That's $120 every time.
Well, they fool, but not observe time.
You goddamn devils, man. You can't even walk down the street without these devils fucking with you, man.
I don't know if we can catch it or not.
How long is your meter going for? Anything else you want to say? We get a couple more scriptures. Get that Zechariah 13, I think, the destruction scripture. The eyes shall melt and all that. Is that 13 or 14? You know what I'm talking about? I think it's 14. Actually. Is it 14? Yeah. Oh, they'll be on it too. How much a parking ticket? $90? I don't know. Fucking faggot ass cop. Just put milk. I got you. Here. No, I got it.
Man, whoa. Shape too.
Yeah.
Healthy.
Yeah. Hey.
Kind of funny. Oh,
It's like your boy that Andre 3000. Right. Fucking crazy ass. Man, I'm slacking, man. We haven't got this scripture in a minute.
What y'all looking for?
Is it Zechariah 13 or 12 or?
Instruction.
Milk. I got it. Yeah, it was 14. Zechariah 14 and 12. And this shall be the plague where Yahweh shall smite all the people that have fought against Jerusalem. Their flesh shall consume away while they stand upon their feet, and their eyes shall consume away in their holes, and their tongue shall consume away in their mouth. So that's the destruction that's coming. That's when those missiles.
Somebody tell you
that
ain't right?
Why else would that is made for?
Oh my God.
We the same way.
Same way, man. Same boat. You know, it's crazy out here, man. It's crazy.
That's why you supposed to pray to the Lord destroys this shit. You supposed to send them prayers every day. Pray to the Lord destroys it.
Yeah, my motherfuckers told me you can't be rewarded.
Oh, they did?
Yeah.
That's some bullshit. That's some faggot cock blocking shit. Yeah, so you got IUIC telling men that they're not allowed to get with a woman based on her appearance. That's what you call faggot shit. That you ain't supposed. That's here it is, the Lord tried to send you
a piece of shit.
Yeah. A witness, though. He's another witness. The Lord said out of the mouth of two or three witnesses, let every word be established. We have multiple, innumerable witnesses that gave us testimony about some wicked shit that IUIC been teaching. Here it is, the Lord send you a woman, and they're going to tell you that you're not allowed to be with her. You'd be happy if you get a woman that living out here to give you a little bit of comfort or something. You know what I mean?
Sit to a weakness.
Yeah.
They be with that woman. They listen.
They will listen too. And then they be single after that. That's faggot shit.
Right. The only pussy they can rely on is their hand. That's some bugged out shit.
That's some faggot shit, bro.
That's some weakness shit.
That's why the Lord gonna
the spirit of adultery.
The Lord gonna beat the shit out of IUIC.
That's all it is, adultery, man. They want that. Woman.
That is adultery. Because, yeah, actually, you're right. Because if they cause that man to leave her, then she's going to go get with somebody else. Right? And that's causing her to commit adultery. That is adultery.
When the old girl that came that left IUIC in testimony, and they told her since her husband ain't in the truth, she got to leave him.
That's faggot shit.
That's adultery. Straight up adultery.
What's up, bro? We out here prophesying the destruction of the kingdom of Satan. You know where the kingdom of Satan is at?
In your heart.
Oh, you're right. But you living in the physical manifestation of the kingdom of Satan, which is known as America.
Okay.
Can't you see it?
Well, it's a melting pot, but there's a lot of corruption.
Yeah, it was built and founded upon corruption. You know? It was built on slavery. Yeah. You know what I mean? Genocide. You know what I'm saying?
So I take you read the scriptures before?
I've read the King James, I read the NIV.
Yeah, King James. Just stick to King James.
King James.
Revelation speaks of the mystery, the daughter of Babylon.
Mystery or Babylon.
That's America.
Yeah, that's America.
Yeah,
that is America.
The Statue of Liberty is the...
Sol Invictus.
What is it?
It was built by Freemasons. It represents the sun god, so that's why he got the sun rays coming off his head.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a pagan idol.
It's a pagan idol, yeah. I've never felt comfortable having that in our harbor showing the rest of the world this is what we believe.
But America was founded by Freemasons, though. You know, George Washington.
I don't believe in Freemasonry.
Right.
I believe it's idolatry, paganism, and the core. And they talk about the Luciferian levels. You know, 33 levels to masonry. That's cool.
What? Yeah, in the script. And they do everything in secret. Yeah, it is bullshit. Like you said, it's bullshit.
Yeah, they do everything in secret and they have all these ceremonies.
The Lord said in secret, he's done nothing. We do everything openly. That's how, you know, a righteous man does everything in the open, does nothing in secret. You know what I mean?
Yeah, well, what you want to be known and what's hidden now will be shouted from the housetops.
Right.
And what you want to be known in your prayer closet will be seen by your Father in heaven.
Right.
And he'll answer your prayer openly.
Right, you see, there you go.
Yeah, so, I mean, I don't know what the big deal is, but if you just go on believing what you believe and get strong in your faith, nothing can stop you.
Exactly.
Nothing we can stop you.
You got power of the Lord, we're unstoppable.
Yeah, I mean, people will slow you down, they'll hinder you, they'll say all sorts of false things. I just went to this church that I went to when I was a kid, and they have a bunch of homosexuals there, and I'm like, no, sorry. I stayed there for like 6 weeks, and I was thinking, I can deal with this. I'll just be friendly to them. And I was like,
because yeah, you
formed a Congo line, and this guy was behind me, and I'm like, no, no,
he's trying,
no.
Rob trying to get his rub on.
That's a sight to see.
Hey, man, you count us. We about to head out, but our meter's about to expire. You need these doubles to give you a ticket if you don't get back to the car.
Yeah, that's good work you're doing. I like to see anybody who's in the town square because it talks about that in Ezekiel.
Oh,
that's
man.
Heavy reading. When you talk about the town square, you know, broad and high.
Yeah, we were just reading that scripture in Ezekiel. You got to warn the people.
You got to warn the people in Isaiah 5, or in Ezekiel 5. But then it talks about the town square a little bit later on in that book.
Right, and the Lord said
reading.
It.
You're supposed to proclaim the good news to people.
The Lord said go to the highways and the byways.
And this is why you got to come out and inspire people's spirit, man. Yeah. Some devils that come out here in the red and the purple.
You
the
seen
purple.
Them?
Yeah, I've
Your motherfuckers would have said you were devil.
Yep.
They wouldn't, you know, and you're one of us.
And he knows scriptures and everything.
Right, you're a Jake, man. You know? You're one of us.
A Jake.
You're an Israelite.
Israelite.
You ain't a white man. You're an Israelite.
I'm an Israelite.
You're an Israelite.
That.
That's why you speak the way you speak, man.
Hey, you know the book of Matthew, right?
I know all the books.
So what did the Lord say?
The Chronicles. I have trouble with the Chronicles reading.
Oh, well, that's heavy some heavy reading, that's heavy studying right there.
Yeah.
But what did the Lord say in Matthew, the 15th chapter? He said, I am not, in Matthew 15:24, he said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
Okay, I'm not sent, but
Shalom, yo.
That's what he meant. Just